In today's video, I am going to explain thoracic outlet syndrome. I am going to explain what that is and its mechanics. Okay, thoracic outlet syndrome is basically there is pain around neck, clavicle, shoulder, and upper extremity all the way down to fingers, or numbness around upper extremity and neck. At the same time, maybe people complain the muscle force decreases. That means their force of muscle is weak. Okay, that is thoracic outlet syndrome. Thoracic outlet syndrome. So, what are causes of this syndrome? Basically, there are two types. One is traction. The other one is compression. What do I mean traction and compression? Let me explain that. So, I should talk about one more thing. That is this yellow bundle. This is brachial plexus. Brachial plexus is bundle of nerves. These nerves go to chest, clavicle, shoulder, arm, and all the way down to fingertips. And I said thoracic outlet syndrome can be caused by two causes, right? Traction and compression. Basically, nervous tissue doesn't like to be compressed nor stretched, okay? So, what do I mean traction? Okay. Basically, this kind of cause is common among female. Why? Because female tends to have less amount of muscles compared to male, right? Then their neck muscles, shoulder muscles are weaker and smaller than male, relatively, right? So their trapezius, their neck muscles are smaller. Then what's going to happen to position of clavicle, scapula, and shoulder? They tend to go to down, right? Because not much muscle force to maintain shoulder position up. Does it make sense? So among female, it's common they have less muscle power to bring shoulder up. In result, their shoulder position goes down. Then what happens to brachial plexus? They are now stretched to downward, right? I said nervous tissue doesn't like to be stretched, right? But in this position, nervous tissue is stretched downward. What's going to happen? There is pain. There is numbness around upper extremity. That is one reason for thoracic outlet syndrome. Traction, stretch. Okay, this is common among female because they have less muscle force to maintain shoulder position up. In result, shoulder position is going down. That pulls brachial plexus downward. Then pain, numbness, and less muscle force happens. That is thoracic outlet syndrome. Simple, right? This is the one reason, that is traction. Let me talk about compression. Okay, I will talk about compression in this picture. Actually, muscles are related to compression reason, okay? There are three types of muscles related to thoracic outlet syndrome. First muscle, actually muscle groups, are these guys. These guys are anterior scalene and middle scalene. Anterior scalene and middle scalene. These are neck muscles. Watch carefully. Between these two muscles, there is brachial plexus. Then what if skating gets tight. There can be compression to brachial plexus. Do you remember? I said, nervous tissue doesn't like being stretched nor compressed. Oh my gosh, there's compression between these two muscles. What's going to happen? There should be pain and numbness. Makes sense. So part one, anterior skating and middle skating. Part two, next part is here, this part, number two. This muscle is subclavius. Subclavius. Actually, this is tiny muscle. What does it matter for thoracic outlet syndrome? Okay, brachial plexus actually runs posterior to clavicle. Okay, posterior to clavicle. Plus, space around clavicle and first rib is very, very narrow, right about here. Okay, even though in normal condition, this space is very, very narrow. What is function of subclavius that elevates first rib or that brings clavicle down? Yes, this muscle brings clavicle down. What's going to happen to space around here? That decreases. Plus, brachial plexus runs posterior to clavicle. Bingo, there is compression around clavicle. So subclavius can pull clavicle down, in result, that compresses brachial plexus. Number two, subclavius. Number three is here. This muscle is pectoralis minor, pec minor. Pectoralis minor. Brachial plexus also runs posterior to pec minor. Same thing, what happens if pec minor gets tight? The space posterior to pec minor is also narrow. Okay, then when this muscle gets tight, of course, there is compression for brachial plexus. This is number three. Number one was anterior skating and middle skating. Number two is subclavius. It's messy right now. Number three is pec minor. Compression tends to happen around these three places. Okay, let's go back to first picture little quick. The first part was about traction, being stretched. This is common among female, right? When shoulder position is going down, nervous tissue is stretched. What's going to happen? Pain and numbness around upper extremity. Number two, compression. Compression tends to happen around muscles and bone. Skating, subclavius, plus clavicle, and pectoralis minor. Thoracic outlet syndrome is very, very common thing. So I hope this video helps you understanding of this symptom. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.